you?
Well, I'm John the Engineer Turmel, and I'm well known for my Let's Local Employment Training software, which has now 3 board candidates in Brantford, as well as me, and 8 board candidates in Toronto, who want to pay students with bus tickets to shovel our snow, use empty capacity, and get something useful for it. Now, that happens to be part of the overall Christian ethos. Paul Corinthians 2, chapter 14. Your abundance should at the present time be a supply for their want, bus seats, so that their abundance can then be a supply for your want, showing snow. Now, same thing with the babies sitting back and forth. This is the essence of Christian finance. I'll front you what you need till you're strong, and then you help me when I'm down. Well, Isaiah 55 said, "You who are hungry and have no money, come, buy and eat." Well, how do you buy when you got no money? It means credit's okay, but a certain kind of credit. Now, Jesus, he didn't really mean do unto others as you'd have them do unto you. He really meant lend unto others as you'd have them lend unto you. Long, sharp, free. And when you do, you end up with that Christian ethos in Paul. Now, the point is, the first Let's in Germany was started by a Catholic priest. First Let's in Toronto was started by Lindsay King, a United minister. The first Let's in the UK, well, several were started by Muslims with the Islamic Party. The point is, all the great religions condemn interest on money because of its destructive effects. And the Let's software allows us to start up a local, interest-free time banking system, and it's now spread around the world. Now, explaining it as bus tickets, that's the best way to get it through to kids, and tax credits for adults.
Thank you, John.
While I'm passionate about broke and unemployed people not being able to pull their share to load, and it's more than that for me, it's a duty. When engineers are given their iron rings, we have to swear an oath of integrity that we can't let systems break down. So when I see something that's impeding those guys from pulling their weight, I gotta speak up, which explains why I've run in all these elections pushing Let's. Now, the neat thing about Let's is there were years when you could Google for anti-poverty system, and Let's would come up. And my favorite sobriquet, and I got a lot of them, including some not nice ones, is if you used to look for anti-poverty engineer, I would come up. And that is the title that pleases me the most when I think of all the people around the world who've been helped by my time bank software. And I've never been able to deliver it to my homies. I'd like to start now.
Excellent. That was probably the first use of the word homies in municipal election history. Allow me just to re-ask the question just halfway through, just to remind everyone of the question. And thank you very much, John, for your answer.
Well, a little creditos for a 1 hour of labor owed may seem like a dinky toy, but when the banks shut down in Argentina, 7 million people ended up using these dinky toys. Now, what would happen if your bank shut down? Well, you aren't broke enough yet to really appreciate how setting up your own local currency can insulate you from that. So, the church's role. Well, like I said, the Catholic Church in that German town became the hub of life for their poor people, enabling babysitting, swapping, and potlucks, and barter fairs. And same thing in Toronto Let's. Again, that church became a hub of life. Now, right now, churches are basically alleviators of pain, right? You sit back and watch the financial system butcher all the victims, and you're there with the band-aids and the food banks, trying to find some way to hold them up, while getting them to do something useful gives them a certain amount of credibility, like the lady from Africa said, where they started their time bank. She said, even the bad boys don't steal no more when they get a legitimate job doing something useful for the group. So, if those preachers in those religions could make their churches hubs of life, well, imagine, you guys, if you just had all connected your databases of your churches together, you would be able to have one heck of a wonderful directory of goods and services. And of course, sure, everybody goes and prints up their own one-hour bills, but they put their Facebook ID on it and it can't be fudged. You can check to see that's the right person. So it's a new world coming, and if the churches don't get involved, well, they're going to be left behind as private people try and save the poor, and you're there with the Band-Aids. Well, back when the banks crashed in Argentina in the 80s, and then in 2000, rather than be laid off, guess what the unions asked to do so they could all keep their jobs? And matter of fact, they ended up hiring more people, and Argentina paid off all its foreign debt by 2006 in 5 years. How'd they do that? Gee, didn't make the news, right? Not our news. The union said, you're not going to lay anybody off. You're going to pay us, instead of bringing a $1 million bond to a bank and getting $1 million in pesos and paying us and taxing it back with interest, pay us $1 million bonds. We'll take them if we can use them for hydro, taxes, medical, and licenses. HTML. Now, province of Ontario could issue just as good quality bond bucks. The city of Brantford could issue bond bucks, municipal bonds. They could issue big ones, why not little ones? And whatever an employee takes, give him a 10% premium in bond bucks, but he's leaving cash in the bank so we can hire another cop or do something else or buy another bus. So the every time you use local currency, you're saving interest at the bank. You're not ducking taxes, and that's the whole purpose of it, always saving the damned usury. So they found a way to do it in Argentina, and when the Russian banks closed in the 1990s, remember that? 750 states and municipalities issued their own bond rubles. And it worked. And 25,000 corporations issued their own McDonald's rubles, Coke rubles, Mercedes-Benz rubles. And it worked, because it's still counterfeit if you try to make a copy. So the point is, these community currencies always pop up when they crash, and then they put them away when they're back on their feet. I'm going to keep so busy shoveling snow that I won't have time. No, you know, I'm working on repealing the marijuana laws, okay? I have 275 sick and dying people in the federal court asking the judge for an exemption to use it once they got cut off. One guy just died of cancer. I have 26 in the federal court of appeal and 8 in the Supreme Court of Canada. So this is a passion for me, because we were lied to when we were told this stuff is fatal and deadly and bad for us. And if you do a search on the internet, you find out it's good for a remarkable number of things. It's almost a miracle herb, and yet we've been lied to. I mean, a big lie, and people have died. Okay? So here's the point. Once marijuana is legal, not many people go on to harder drugs. And once marijuana is legal, less people stay on harder drugs. And the last great story of all is, in the States, the bookies have spoken. High drivers have less accidents, less payouts, which means that we're going to need designated high drivers to keep the drunks and the streets off the roads. So that's basically my answer. Legalize the herb, we won't have too many drug problems, and give them bond or bus bucks jobs. Keep them busy, they won't have time. What are you, a cat?
If we could, refrain from that, that would be wonderful. Please, if we
need much more drug education. It needs to come from the mayor's office about the truth about drugs, about the truth about some of these entry-level drugs with marijuana. I can't believe the people who think that marijuana is a safe drug. It's not. It's very dangerous to your mental health. Very dangerous. I've heard people over and over share with me that they had trauma in their life. Somebody gave them marijuana. Now they have two big problems. They still have the trauma that they have to deal with, post-traumatic stress disorder, and they have all the problems that marijuana has brought into their life.
Another man that Guinness Book of World Records says is the most qualified person to answer this question. John.
Most experienced, that's right. They love saying, anyway, can't do that, bro. I practice my accordion in old folks' homes for the last 11 years, so that if you know any oldsters in those homes, good chance that I was the last good time a lot of them ever had. So there's a lot of people up there waiting for me to get up there, and they hope they got accordions too. So, but my point is, does anybody object to my getting a one-hour bill when I play my accordion for those oldsters in those rooms? Our networks say that's a valuable contribution to society. Well, guess what? When you're there, and if I show up, you'll feel so too. So, now, jeez. Here's why. Back in 2003, I always practice. I'd never do it otherwise. But in 06, the judge condemned me to 3 years of probation playing my accordion in old folks' homes, or even put me in jail for going on Parliament Hill with 7 pounds of marijuana instead of a life sentence. Well, I made him drop 4,000 charges, but the point is this. Neurogenesis, the growth of new brain cells, happens when you smoke marijuana, which must explain why I'm so sharp and you're so dull.
Thank you.
Okay, no yucks till the end. Fukushima, we've been fooked. Okay? Since Fukushima, before the plume hit the West Coast, Health Canada turned off their fallout detectors. They didn't want to scare us, and baby deaths tripled. And we've been sucking in fallout for 3 years. Have your fish in your ponds died? You notice how your plants stopped growing suddenly? If that happened to you, wake up! The point is, guess what? When I talked about marijuana earlier and everybody thought it was to get high, I'm talking about the juice and the oil that are proven to kill the cancers that are probably growing in all of us right now. Small so far, but you don't ingest radioactivity and not get it at some point. And oldsters die faster. Have a lot of old friends gone like in a month? Is it an incredible number of funerals we're attending? Well, anyway, that is scary stuff. So that's why I talked about the marijuana. And if we do not decommission nuclear, if Fukushima goes, the next plant, the people are going to die, then their cooling stops, and it goes. And the next, and the next, and the next, and that's a cascade that will destroy the planet. Wow. And nobody's doing anything about it because they got no money. Okay? A company, a private company, is in charge of running and cleaning up the greatest disaster in the history of mankind, where baby deaths already tripled, and nobody's doing anything. Well, we got to fix money to get there. But, last point, Sydney installs machines that offer bus tickets in exchange for recycling. Hey, they might think about offering bus tickets in exchange for students working. You never know what we can do with bus tickets. The point is, if Sydney can do it, I can do it. And if you end up humping your buns, shoveling the snow after the plow passes and you see kids on the corner, I'm laughing last.
Thank you, John. And finally, Jay Manchester.